Okay, it's nearly half time. We're about to head down to do it, and I'm pretty confident.
Are you?
Yeah, do it.
It looks completely different. You're about to see. Doesn't look like the park anymore.
Thanks, Michael. We entered the stadium as the crowd went crazy for me.
That was a coincidence, Mitch. The game was still going. It's a long walk to the small court, but I was behind him all the way.
Even the Wildcats captain Damian Martin was excited to see the worm.
Not this one. I took Mitch through his pre-worm warm-up.
I caught up with some fans.
I am the trainer for Mitch today. There's like 10 minutes in this quarter and we can go on at any minute. So it's a very bizarre feeling. Like I could literally have to go in 1 second. I could go in 9 minutes. So you might be with me for a short time or a long time.
It was a long time.
And with that siren, it finally means that it's time for... With a timeout called Finally, the moment Mitch has been waiting his whole life for had arrived. Could Mitch actually do this?
But first, pre-game yoga, as you can see on Michael Campbell. Come on, Mitch! Come on! Come on, Mitch! Come on, yeah!
And in 10 seconds, it was all over. He'd done it.
Just a quick bow to the crowd. What would I say?
Like Neil Armstrong, these next words could go down in history, remembered forever.
We did it! We did it!
No, Mitch. You did it.
And then we quickly ran off the court as the giant men seemed eager to continue their game of ball and hoop.
19.86 metres. Smashed it by like six whole metres in 10 seconds. 19 metres. Nearly 20.
I'm sorry, guys, but apologise for asking another half, another quarter of basketball. But hey, enjoy it. Enjoy it.
The early bird. Look at the sweat. The early bird gets the worm.
Gently setting a new world record for the longest worm in 10 seconds. In front of the Red Army, he wobbled his way to 19.86 metres.
That's a bad effort.